गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई एम शोभित एंड दिस इज टी ओ पी जी टास्क नंबर 14. इन दिस टास्क आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग ऑन अ टॉपिक यूजिंग फ्यू techniques that I have learned in the course. So today I will be discussing about financial planning. First of all, why financial planning is important? See, we all have some goals in our life and few of them require money. For example, if I want to buy a car, then I can do two things. I can take car loan and pay more amount than required, or I can plan and then buy a car when I have gathered enough capital. So this is in with respect to that. Second option is that we want to be ahead of inflation. So question is, what is inflation? Inflation is nothing but the rate at which the things are getting more and more expensive. To better understand the inflation, let's go to second slide. The inflation rate for last year was 4.7%, and the projected inflation for next year is 5%. So let's suppose you have 100 rupees and currently you can buy 2 liters of milk with that 100 rupees. What will happen next year? If the rate of inflation is 5%, then the same 2 bottles of milk will cost 105 rupees. Similarly, if you don't do anything with that 100 rupees, the value of that 100 rupees will be stagnant at 100 rupees. It will be similar to if you have just put that money in cash under your bed, it will not grow. But if you put it in FD, which in today's scenario is giving a 5% annual return, so your 100 rupees will become 105 and they will match the inflation. So still, if you see in this case when you did nothing with the money, the money depreciated. But when you put it in FD, the money appreciated. It appreciated, but it did not increase the value of that money. 100 year today with rate of inflation at 5% will be equal to 105 rupees after 1 year. There is no change in the value of that amount of money. So with proper financial planning, you can either fulfill your goals, and you can also beat the inflation. So let's go to financial planning. How do we go about it? So first step of the financial planning can be to create goals. Now goal can be anything. It can be if you want to buy a car, or if you want to buy a house, if you want to save for your child's education or his marriage. The first step is to create a goal. Create the proper duration of that goal. Second thing to do is learn more about your finances. Understand how finances work. One of that I just explained you is inflation. Third one is create budget. Understand how much money you have coming in and how much money you have going out. How much are your expenses? It may sound tedious in the start, but in the long run it creates a big impact. Well, when you have understood these three things, proceed and save all that you can in various funds or schemes or anywhere that you like. Now let's go to creating goals. This actually I have already discussed. So once again, goals can be anything. It can be if you want to buy a home, or if you want to buy a car, if you want to save for your child education, or it can be for your retirement. अगर आप retirement के लिए पैसा बचाना चाहते हैं तो ये भी उसमें काम करेगा. सेकेंड स्टेप क्या होता है इसमें, कि आपको ड्यूरेशन सेट करनी पड़ती है. अब जैसे अगर आपको घर खरीदना है तो कितने साल में खरीदना है, या फिर अगर आप अपने बच्चे के एजुकेशन के लिए सेव कर रहे हैं तो आपके पास कितना टाइम ड्यूरेशन है, और उसी के अकॉर्डिंग प्लान करते हैं. लेट्स टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ, सपोज आपको अपने बच्चे के लिए इन्वेस्ट करना है. द बेस्ट स्कीम फॉर दिस इज यू शुड जस्ट इन्वेस्ट इन म्यूचुअल फंड. आई ऑल्सो टेल यू हाउ. There is a thing called SIP calculator in grow.in. So if you want, you can just go there and search for SIP calculator, which is somewhere here. Okay, I will just give you an overview what will happen. Suppose you want to save 1 crore rupees for your child, for your children education, और आपके पास टोटल ड्यूरेशन है 20 साल. अगर आप म्यूचुअल फंड में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं तो उसका जनरली एवरेज रिटर्न आता है 12% एनुअल, एंड इट इज ऑलवेज कंपाउंडेड. सो अगर आपने बचपन में कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट या फिर चक्रवृद्धि ब्याज पढ़ा हो तो वही इसमें काम करता है. अगर आप 10,009 रुपये पर महीना बचा सकते हैं तो आप उसको किसी अच्छे म्यूचुअल फंड में इन्वेस्ट कर दीजिए। हर महीने SIP कहा जाता है इसको। एंड देन आफ्टर डूइंग दिस फॉर कंटिन्यूअसली फॉर 20 ईयर्स, आपने टोटल पैसा जो इन्वेस्ट करा होगा दैट विल बी अराउंड 24 लाख। बट आपको जो रिटर्न आएगा ऑन 12% इंटरेस्ट रेट का कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट रेट, इट विल टोटल अमाउंट टू 1,472 रुपीज। दिस इज वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ प्लानिंग योर फाइनेंसेज। देर आर मैनी एंड देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ यूट्यूब वीडियोज। यूट्यूब पे बहुत कुछ कंटेंट पड़ा है इसके बारे में। अगर आप करना चाहते हैं जस्ट डू सिंपल सर्च और आपको मिल जाएगा क्या करना है। थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर लिसनिंग।